introduction about how to use the Bosch FSA 050 multimeter testing Bosch common rail solenoids. So we're going to go through two different tests. We're going to go to a terminal-to-terminal resistance test and a voltage leak test. Okay, today we're going to be testing Bosch common rail solenoids with the Bosch FSA 050. First thing we need to do is open the toolkit. We're going to need the red test lead with the black test button on it, and we're going to need the black test lead with no button. In the kit you will find alligator clips and test lead covers, along with a red test lead without a button. There's a very large difference between the two. We need the one with the button. For this test, we will not be using the alligator clips or the test lead covers. We're going to plug the red test lead into the back, followed by the black test lead. For the Bosch common rail injector, we're going to go through two different tests. One will be a terminal-to-terminal resistance test, and the other one will be a voltage leak test. We've got the FSA 50 out of the box. The first thing we're going to want to do is make sure that our leads are zeroed. And the way we're going to do that is we're going to turn the dial down to the ohms section. It's a little orange section down here at the bottom left. It will come up and say basically greater than 100 ohms and nothing else on the screen. So what we're going to do then is touch the two leads together. Okay? And right now I'm getting a reading of 0.4849. It's kind of fluctuating in there. So we want to touch the two leads together. Right? Here's 0.49, so that's pretty consistent. After it kind of settles down a little bit, we're going to hit the black test button. As soon as I do, all of a sudden the reading will go to 0.00, and down at the bottom left-hand corner there's going to be a little circle, a little half moon over it with a couple of arrows on it. Now that means that the leads are now zeroed, or very close to zero. This is very, very critical that these things are zeroed, because if not, then as soon as you test a solenoid, it will give you 0.49 plus the resistance of the solenoid, as opposed to the outright reading. So if we don't zero the leads, essentially every solenoid that we test will be out of spec, because 0.48 is already out of spec. So if the solenoid has any resistance at all, then it'll already be bad. So we're going to test those two together and hit the black test button after we have some stabilization there. The gauge will read 0.00, and down at the bottom left-hand corner we'll have a dark circle with a little half moon on it with a couple of arrows. That's where we want to be. Now we're ready to test an injector. So first, there's no real polarity assigned to each one of the terminal posts on the solenoid. So it doesn't matter where the black lead goes to which side. So touch the black lead to one terminal post. Anywhere on the post is okay. And touch the red lead to the other one. And that's going to give you a reading on the screen. So right now I've got 0.36. And that one's good. We're going to look for anything between a range of 0.2 to 0.4. Usually anything outside the 0.4 range will experience some problems. Now that we've tested the terminal-to-terminal resistance, we're going to go over and check the voltage leak, which is the second test that we're going to do. In order to test the voltage leak, we're going to turn the dial up to the 100-volt signal. The screen's going to go blank, and it is just waiting for us, basically. So what we're going to do now is we're going to touch the black lead to one of the terminals. Either one, again, is okay. We're going to take the red lead and we're going to touch the metal body of the solenoid with the red lead. After we've done that, we're going to hold down the test button until numbers start to appear. And as you can see here, we've got some numbers showing up. So we've got 110 volts and it looks like about 2 mega ohms. So what we want is 111 volts. That's 109 is no good. So we want 111 volts. That is the most important thing. The top number will be the voltage reading. The bottom number is the resistance reading. You have to be very careful with the resistance reading at the bottom because the unit will change. It will change units without letting you know. So it will change between kilo-ohms, mega-ohms, and giga-ohms even without alerting you. So the bottom right-hand corner, you can see the big M in front of the ohm. That's for mega-ohm. And then, let's see if I hit it real quick. No, it won't go to kilo-ohm for me. But it'll even go to giga-ohms. So again, you can test it out of the injector. So anywhere on the copper terminal, and then against the solenoid body itself, and we're going to hold that down. So this one's 111 volts. That's good. Now, as you can see, sometimes there is a significant delay in the reading for the ohms. And you can see that this one is measuring 1.5 gigaohms, which is a lot. So that's actually very good. So that we really want to use that one. But sometimes that reading will delay. The voltage will pick up very quickly, and sometimes the resistance will drag a little bit. So just hold it on there until you get the actual reading. And as soon as you do, then you'll know good or bad. So again, the top number, we're looking for a minimum value of 110. The bottom number, the ohms reading, we're looking for a minimum value of 800 kiloohms, or 0.8 megaohms. But it needs to be 800 kiloohms as a minimum value. There is no maximal value. I think if you just hold it in the air, air resistance will be around, I think it'll say greater than 20 gigaohms when you do this. So we're not really looking for a maximum value. But the minimum value we're going to accept is 0.8 megaohms or 800 kiloohms, whichever one it displays. And we're also looking for 110 volts as a minimum as well.